Ah, it's good to be at sea again, but I don't much like that sky.
Even a pretty sunrise is a bad omen to you, Mr. Faulkner. Where are these raiders?
By guess and by God, an easterly course toward the coast. Miss Mandy reports of some British boats gathering somewhere in these rocks, threatening the vineyard. British gunboats after one of the vineyard ships, Captain. We must protect her. Draw their fire, Captain. We need to keep the gunboats off her till she reaches the vineyard pier. After them, sir. They'll have her before long. Captain, destroy them or use them to our advantage. Either way, avoid the blasted things.
To our advantage, how?
Shoot them! Thank you. You should be safe now, but it's a hot chase. Get after them and end the threat on the vineyard. They veered north. Not there, but an abandoned fort. Shouldn't be there.
Well, it is there, Mr. Faulkner.
And it's too close to the vineyard. Time and time waits for no man. Take out their power.
Nice driving, Captain.
Have gone too far this time.
That is the problem. What reason would the English have to threaten Martha's Vineyard? It has no strategic value and its people remain peaceful. I fear an influence of a different kind saw to this.
Templars.
But what they intend, I do not know.
Your orders?
I need time to piece things together. We set a course for home.
Aye, aye.
Thank you.
trust her?
With my life, Captain.
Hello! Name's Amanda. You must be the captain.
Now, what's all this about, then?
You stride into my bar off the piss and looking for officers. Days later, I start hearing whispers the ghost of the North Seas stalks the Atlantic again. The Aquila has returned, and I need her help. Nicholas Biddle now sails for the Patriots, captaining the Randolph. But the man is raiding up and down the coast round Nantucket, claiming it's a loyalist post.
Where is he now?
Speak of the devil.
Head below deck, Mandy. It's safer there.
I want to see this myself. Randolph is attacking a merchant vessel not far from here.
Your orders.
We need to find out what Biddle intends, but we must hurry. What else do you know of Biddle?
All of a sudden, Congress has a brand new ship for him to captain. From British coxswain to captain of a colonial flagship, something doesn't add up. Heavy gusts, Captain! Hard counter! That wind will push us hard up those rocks! Veer off! There's a storm coming, Captain. Feels like a big one.
leave this merchant vessel to the mercy of the English.
Why is Biddle doing this? Nantucket is for the Patriots!
The company can keep serving its true allegiance by Delta.
Jibs.
Where's the Randolph?
He's gone, sir. Cut and run. Left us to deal with this rabble. But this storm concerns me a great deal more.
We have little choice.
Aye. Time your shots to keep away, sir. Then we must find shelter, or it won't be cannon fire that ends up. To me a great deal more. Aye. Time your shots between the waves, sir. Then we must find shelter. Or it won't be cannon fire that ends up.
I have never seen weather like that.
It's rare, but it happens. I did well. What's bothering me is Biddle's a patriot now. Why is he helping the British Navy like that? Old friends, maybe?
Well, how would you convince the Continental Congress the Navy needs more ships?
The rash of British raiding the coast is reason enough to address the gripe. Gunboats at the Vineyard, now this.
Biddle aims to be the first admiral of the Colonial Navy and is making a case for the need.
That was some deft sailing, Captain. I was watching from the gun deck.
What were you doing on the gun deck? I told you to stay out of harm's way.
I'm fine, Bobby, not to worry. The people of Nantucket are surely grateful. And so am I. Glad you're back.
Our charge, Captain. The Belladonna, under Rodrigo Hortalis and Company. She appears Spanish for all intents and purposes, but rest assured she's a French vessel.
French are bringing in a boatload of powder and guns for old Georgie and his patriots. Some colonial boats were supposed to escort her up the coast, but they left her behind. She's been waiting ever since.
We will make sure Washington gets what he is expecting.
Where is le capitaine?
I am the captain.
You are late!
We came as quickly as the wind allowed.
Too slow!
What happened to your escort?
Le Randolph started with us, then departed without warning. Typique! This is why le lieutenant insisted I come aboard. Partons!
We'll go when we're good and bloody ready.
What?
The Atlantic is a dangerous place for a lone shipper, especially one laden with such desirable stock. You must be glad to see us.
Boss,
it is hot here. My lieutenant is not excited for the cold of the north.
Is this man being serious?
Keep a sharp eye, Mr. Faulkner. Anybody searching for the Belladonna could be upon us in an instant with this fog.
Aye, Captain. I've got a monkey's fist in me gut.
English are on us, Captain!
The power of the French Navy is clear!
They picked the wrong ship to pirate! Why in God's name are the English here in such force?
I do not know, but we must get the Belladonna out of this fog.
In this soup, and you can be sure they're far on the way.
But what can we do?
Nought but pray they don't find us again.
The Belladonna's main mast is down, Capitaine! We must stay close to her!
No! We board her. I must know how the English knew about the Belladonna.
We take her aside, men!
Board her? Et tu fou?
How does the British command know about the Belladonna?
British command knows nothing of this.
Then how are you here?
We were led here by a patriot, Nicholas Biddle.
Who does Biddle work for?
Oh, I think you know. Assassin.
What did the captain tell you?
Nicholas Biddle led them here. He said... The Randolph.
The Randolph?
Beat to quarters!
Belay that order!
He is putting us to his rudder. We cannot leave the Belladonna undefended.
But sir!
She is incapacitated and vulnerable. Let him go. We will see each other again soon.
You see the catch forward, Captain!
Anything, Captain?
Due north of here.
What's that weasel up to? Sheet anchor to windward, Captain. You can be sure he's got something up his sleeve. I knew he was up to something. And he's turned to fight us. We're in it now, Captain.
So we fight, Mr. Faulkner. Board the Randolph. Sink the rest.
Thank you.
It's a bloody armada. I knew he was up to something. And he's turned to fight us. We're in it now, Captain.
So we fight, Mr. Faulkner. Board the Randolph. Sink the rest.
The damage you've done to the Randolph. Come on, you savage. Give me your best. I will make you suffer for the damage you've done to the Randolph.
Your reign over the Colonial Coast has come to an end.
Is that why you hunted me?
Because you thought me an enemy to the cause. You're every bit the fool I was told.
You brought pain and suffering upon innocent people for nothing but personal gain.
Pain, suffering. I set them free. Weeded out the dissenters and empowered the patriots. So what if I was named Admiral? The revolution needs one, and I was the best man for the job. The only man. If not for me, the Continental Navy would remain but a handful of rafts. For all your vision, you assassins are blind to the truth.
Enough.
Wait. Let the Randolph die with me. Don't take her as a prize. Please. Please. I want no quarter. Just to sink with my ship.
I can't believe you mean to leave the Randolph. She's a mighty vessel, Captain, and what a fiddle. You show him mercy in the face of... Well, I guess that's that, then. Tad overdramatic, if you ask me. Still, a waste of a formidable ship. How's about a cheer for the boys, then, eh?
Victory for the Aquila! For her glory! Hip, hip, hip!